Jaguar Land Rover says its entire range of cars will be electric within the decade. British Prime Minister Boris Johnson hailed the announcement on Twitter. The automaker CEO tells CNN it's all part of a sweeping overhaul for the company.
By 2026, we will have more than 6 electric vehicles being offered with Land Rover in a pure electric mode for our customers. And it means that for Land Rover, by the end of the decade, and Jaguar together, at the end, we will offer all our range of cars with pure electric drivetrain. And that's the reason why, a couple of years later, we estimate to be ready and commit for a zero carbon company by 2039.
Okay, now the announcement you've released today says you will substantially reduce and rationalize non-manufacturing infrastructure. Does that translate to job losses? And if so, how many and where?
No, the reality is that the activities that we are performing at the moment are very much scattered for the non-manufacturing activities around the UK. That's part of the legacy. And the goal is to concentrate, to rationalize those activities, including, and that's an exploration that we are performing at the moment, because of the future repurposing of Castle Bromwich site. So it's more a translation, you know, of activity than just a reduction of activity.
It's certainly not been an easy year, has it? Last quarter, though, you saw a strong recovery in sales in China, but of course, overall, well below the levels you saw pre-pandemic. When do you expect to see a return to normal in terms of sales? And actually, do you worry that the pandemic will have had some sort of long-term behavioral impact? People working from home, do they need cars?
For the moment, I cannot tell you exactly when we expect to recover, but the trend is pretty attractive, I can tell you, to recover from what has happened during COVID. Concerning people working at home, I think we have learned a new flexibility, and we want to enjoy, like many companies, of that flexibility. It doesn't mean, at the end of the day, that for our customers, at least in the segments that we are in, and we want to be even more on those segments, the reality would be a decrease compared to a pre-COVID period of time.
Mr. Bollore, Apple is rumored to be entering the market. Does that worry you? There'd be a formidable rival. Or, of course, would you be interested in partnering with them?
No, I think it makes a lot of sense that the tech company are getting interested in the car company. Why? Because the car is visibly, for all of us, the next connected object. And it's an expectation as well from all our customers. So far, we can offer seamless experiences, you know, through the mobility, thanks to this connectivity, enhanced connectivity.
Have you had any discussions with Apple?
Oh, you know, we are discussing with everyone, all leaders of the industry we have discussion with, and it's part of the way we are always envisaging the next partnerships that we may have.
Nissan is the latest automaker denying it's in talks to develop a car with Apple. Nissan shares dropped nearly 3% in Tokyo on the news. Hyundai and Kia said they were out last week after confirming negotiations just a month earlier. That makes for a shrinking list of potential partners for Apple, who have flirted with entering the car industry for years. The car coach, Lauren Fix, joins us live now. So, Lauren, we've seen a couple of times now these potential partnerships that are rumored between Apple and various other car companies, be it Hyundai, be it Nissan, seem to fall apart. Why are these deals or these arrangements or even just discussions suddenly being scuppered?
Well, you have to remember, car manufacturers know exactly where to save money, how to spend money, how to share platforms and technology. And so when Apple comes in and say, we want our vehicle our way and not the Hyundai way, the Kia way, the Nissan way. And so that presents a problem because manufacturing already we're having a shortage of chips. And for them to produce a whole new product line and a whole new production line, that would create some interesting situations. What it would also do is make the dealer networks, if you think about where people are going to buy these, yeah, you could order them online from the Apple store, but still service needs to be handled. And that's where it's going to be interesting, that there's going to be some sort of partnership with these manufacturers. So it's not just the manufacturer, it's the dealer network with their franchising rules as well. So I think that's an issue And I always wonder with Apple, they had the Titan project going and then they stopped. And that was what was their autonomous electric vehicle. And I think what they realized is there's not a lot of money in producing short run production cars. You have to produce a lot. It's not a phone. It's not an earbud. It's not a watch. It's not a computer. This is a whole different animal that has to have a certain experience. And if you're going to use a brand name like Hyundai, Kia, or Nissan, you better share that experience. And I think the manufacturers want to have a piece of that as well.
So what should the consumer know about what potential Apple car will look like? I mean, what's it going to, I mean, obviously there's been so much secrecy about, you know, what they're planning exactly. But, you know, just in terms of your knowledge, what do you think an Apple car will and should be able to do? And should the rest of the car industry be scared, do you think?
Oh, the rest of the car industry should be very scared. If they figure it out and they do it properly, you know they're going to take a big piece of this pie. Well, first off, there are no autonomous cars. But even if they come up with an electric vehicle that you can drive in the interim, you're still looking at Apple's name in itself has great brand recognition. I'm using an Apple earpiece. I have Apple watches. I'm using all Apple devices. So I tend to be loyal to that brand, and so are millions and millions of people. So think about this. You are a smaller car company like Mitsubishi, and then you show up on the scene with an Apple car. They're not going to be very happy to lose a piece of that segment, whether it be cars, SUVs, or trucks. So I think when Apple comes on the scene, it's going to be strong. It's going to be a modern vehicle. But what Apple needs to remember is that consumers are more than just the look of the vehicle. It's the functionality. It's the where you sit, the comfort of the seating. So a lot more than just a phone or an earpiece. It's the comfort, the visibility, the technology, the features, what's offered, what's extra, the cost, the warranty. All these things start to add up and play. And yeah, there's Apple Car. You know, they have Apple Care on all their devices. Sure, you can buy that. But there's still a little bit more to the drivability and the safety. And I think that's where partnering with a brand is the smartest thing Apple can do.
And that brings me to my next question. Does that eventually change the landscape of the car industry? Do you think that what we're going to be seeing is more and more car companies thinking that in order to innovate, in order to be a product of the future, they really have to work with tech companies? Is that going to be the future?
Well, we're already seeing that. Yeah, you're right. And I think that is going to be one of the things you're going to see. But keep in mind, making this world all electric, there's not enough power on the grid. When you're talking about snow and weather that impacts the ability for solar panels to function or for the windmills to function, this is a huge problem. So I think in the end, what we're going to be looking at is some really cool tech merging in with car companies. You'll see a lot of really nice hybrid technology that gets great fuel economy, but you will have gas and diesel and compressed natural gas and hydrogen and electric if that's your choices. But I think there needs to be choices because everybody has a different situation.
Right. Lauren Fix, live for us there. Thank you so much.